In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the MEN platform, which was released in April of 2024. For our existing SCA users, the MEN platform offers a significant upgrade and enhanced features. Current users of MEND will be very familiar with this user interface, which I'll refer to as the legacy MEND interface for the duration of this video. When the MEND platform is enabled in an organization, it can be accessed by selecting MEND platform from the application selection menu in the upper left. This will open up a new window or tab, depending on how your browser is configured. Note that all SCA data is available in both the MEND platform and the legacy interface. Users may wish to transition to the MEND platform when they are ready. Users can switch back and forth between the interfaces at any time simply by selecting a different tab. Also know that the legacy interface can be accessed from the MEND platform by clicking on the gear icon and selecting the legacy platform. The MEND platform follows a similar organizational structure as the legacy interface. Your organizations, if you have more than one, will be selectable in this box. Products have been renamed applications. They are the same thing, buckets that hold projects. The three-dimensional symbol next to the applications menu item is a reminder that it holds projects. Now I'll take you through the many advantages of the MEND platform over the legacy interface. One of the key features of the MEND platform is that it centralizes the results from all of MEND's scanning technologies, SCA, static analysis, and container scanning. These buttons allow you to toggle results from each scanner in case you'd like to focus on one or two scanners. For example, if all you care about is SCA, but you have results from the other scanners. Note that if you have not subscribed to these other features, they will be grayed out. On the main dashboard, findings are summarized by severity. This includes CVEs from SCA and container scanning, and CWEs from static analysis scanning. Hovering over the bars identifies which scanners identified the risk. The trend graph shows changes over time in findings, remediations, and suppressions. If desired, results can be filtered by backlog, which are findings in the first scan to a project, or new, which are findings from all but the first scan. Below the trends graph, the top 10 high-risk applications and projects are shown. Let's go ahead and dive into one of the applications. Once we open an application, we see a summary of the results from all scans. This is similar to the product view in the legacy user interface. We see the number of products that are here, in this case, two. Hovering over the bars in the severity widget shows us the findings breakdowns for each scanner. Below the overall findings are summaries for each scanner. For static analysis or code, hovering over the severity bars shows the breakdown of CWEs that were discovered. This allows you to quickly identify frequently occurring CWEs. Static analysis findings are mapped to various compliance standards. The compliance widget shows the breakdown for the various standards MEND supports. These can also be clicked on to open a report specific for the compliance domain. SCA findings are summarized in the dependency section. Here we see the breakdown of severity as defined by CVSS scores, license risks, and top licenses. These elements are clickable so you can view the details behind the summary. Results from container scans are in the last section. A similar breakdown of CVE risk is provided, and the secret summary provides information about the number of detected secrets. These two are clickable should you want to dive into the details. Now, let's take a look at some of the enhanced capabilities of the MEND platform. Clicking into the SCA results, we are presented with the root library view. This view is a significant improvement over the legacy interface. Listed are the top level or root dependencies that have vulnerabilities in them or their transitives. Pulling up the details for library allows us to view the full dependency tree and see which libraries have CVEs. Here we can see the aggregated CVEs for each level in the tree and collapse or expand as needed. This allows developers to quickly identify the source of the CVE. Further, the recommended fix screen shows MEND's suggestion for remediating all the vulnerabilities in the dependency tree. Compare this to the legacy interface, where we're presented with a list of vulnerable libraries and information that tells us if they are direct or transitive dependency. While we can click into the library details and view the impact analysis, there is no single view that shows us the entire dependency tree and its risk. The root library view in the MEND platform significantly speeds up understanding the source of risk and how to mitigate it. The views in the legacy interface are available in the MEND platform as well. The library's view is similar to the per library's alert view we just looked at, and this also allows you to suppress findings on a per library basis. It includes the direct and transitive status of the library and indicates the direct library if it is a transitive, just as we have in the legacy interface. Note here, we also include the reachability status if you scanned a language that MEND supports for reachability scanning. The findings view is similar to the per vulnerability alerts and allows you to research and manage individual CVEs. For example, you might choose to suppress a particular CVE, and you can do that from the screen, or a group of CVEs by selecting these boxes and choosing the suppress action. Also note that on all of these screens, there's an export to CSV button. This provides a fast way to export data as you see it on your screen. Some of the reports in the legacy interface are now simply an export from one of the screens. More complex reports are available on the reports menu, such as dependency attribution, risk reports, due diligence, SBOMs, and more. Note that the MEND repository integration and MEND Renovate are not affected by the use of the MEND platform. They will continue to raise pull requests and generate issues or work items, regardless of which interface is used to view the results. Another important feature added to the MEND platform is the ability to quickly confirm if a CVE exists in your entire inventory across your organization. This is done from the Finding menu. Here, we simply enter the CVE and search for it. If the CVE is present, it will show up in this list and will tell us which application and project it's in as well, and you can take further action from here. Let's compare to how we do a similar workflow in the legacy user interface. We'd use the global search, which we can access by clicking on the search icon up here. Of course, we'll want to select vulnerability. Then we enter the CVE number of interest and click search. Instead of being presented with a list of results and clickable projects that contain the CVE, we're simply told that it's here in the inventory, and then we need to click view to pull up that list. Depending on the number of projects and products in your legacy user interface, as well as the number of vulnerabilities, this might take some time, whereas it's significantly streamlined in the Mend platform. Here, we can see the CVE in the description of it, the library or libraries that are susceptible to it, and the list of projects where this can be found. Unlike the Mend platform, this is simply a list and you can't click through. You'll have to write down or remember the names of these projects and then go up to the projects menu to select them. The findings menu in the Mend platform provides this information much faster and with fewer clicks. This can be especially useful when you're dealing with a critical or high severity vulnerability, and you want to quickly determine if it's in your organization, and if so, where the vulnerable library is used. Another significant new feature in the Mend platform are labels. Labels, which are managed by a system administrator, can be assigned to any application or project. Multiple labels can be assigned if needed. Here, you can see the list of labels I've created, and over here, we can see which applications have labels assigned. These can be used on the dashboard and other views to filter the results to the applications and projects that have the assigned labels. For example, let's take a look at all of my applications and projects that have been tagged with the internal flag. Or I can look at just the externals or the internals and the externals. With labels, you can create a matrix that overlays the application and product hierarchy, allowing you to quickly filter results to what matters. Note that tags, or key value pairs, continue to be available for application and products via the API. If you have scripts that utilize tags via the API, they will continue to function regardless of the use of the Mend platform or legacy interface. Another important feature added to the Mend platform is scan history. Here, I'm looking at our Java application with two projects. If I go to the scans menu, I'll see an aggregated list of all the scans from all scan technologies. We can see which project received the scan, and we can drill down into any scan and see its result. For example, if I want to go back and look at an SCA scan from the end of April, I can do that. With scan history, we no longer need to create separate projects for snapshots that we want to keep. The Mend platform easily manages scan history for every project. If you're a Mend customer and is using Mend static analysis and Mend container scanning in addition to dependency scanning, this information is readily available in the Mend platform as well. I've already shown you the summaries, but let's dive into the details for static analysis. Here, we'll take a look at a SQL injection. You'll see we have all the results from the static analysis scan, including the vulnerable line of code and the full data flow analysis. It should we need to review it. At this point, you may want to triage the CWE and determine how you want to move forward. If you know you want to suppress it, that's easy to do by clicking the suppress button. You can also create an issue in Jira if you have enabled our Jira integration. If you're unsure what to do, the CWE description can be very helpful. Here, we see the standard description of the CWE, in this case, CWE 89. And remediation recommendations are provided below. You also see the mappings to the various compliance domains that's used for the summaries I showed you before, and can also be used to generate reports should you be interested in reporting on specific compliance domains relevant for your applications. Back to the remediation recommendations. If you're an experienced developer, this may be all you need to review to know how to remediate the problem. However, if you're not sure what to do, we have training available in the Mend platform as well. Through a partnership with Secure Code Warrior, we offer interactive and video training at no additional cost. Training can be accessed with a single click from these links. The first training link provides an interactive training course, which is really helpful for people who like to actually get hands-on, and it involves reading and writing code to resolve the problem. The video course would be like watching a YouTube video. This is extremely helpful if you have developers who have different learning styles. They can pick the training course that's appropriate for their needs. For the more experienced developers, these publicly available documentation and cheat sheets may be all they need to remind them of how to deal with a SQL injection. These training links are also available in the Mend repository integrations, so developers don't necessarily need to visit the Mend platform to get these links. With the training resources from Secure Code Warrior and public sources, Mend helps significantly speed up the time it takes for developers to understand findings and remediate them. Moving over to container scanning, the results are available here. We can see the CVEs found within the container, what package has that CVE, and if the CVE is reachable. Further, if you're an assisted customer, you can enable an integration that will tell you if the package is actually active in your Kubernetes cluster. This does require a separate contract with Sysdig. On the packages screen, we can see the list of packages found in the container, a summary of the CVEs for each of these packages, runtime reachability if the Sysdig integration is used, Mend reachability, and layer information. And of course, the data on all of these screens can easily be exported. On the Secrets tab, we'll see if the Mend container scan found any files that contain secret information. In this example, Mend container found an asymmetric private key. You can see the path to the file here. And we can see that it's actually a PEM file. Note that the scanner didn't simply trigger on a PEM file. It looked inside the file and found that there was an RSA private key in the text of the file. With the Mend platform, we're able to see the results of all of the scanning technologies used in a given project. You no longer need to switch between views to review aggregated summaries and drill into the detailed results. If you've been using API 1.x or API 2.0 to retrieve and manage information in the legacy interface, know that it will continue to work with the Mend platform. However, the older APIs only provide information on SCA. If you want to use APIs to access information on static analysis and container scanning, you'll need to use API 3.0. It's fully documented on the Mend documentation site and is available with both Swagger and an open API specification documents to allow you to easily integrate with API tools such as Postman. This concludes the overview of the Mend platform. Thank you for taking time to view it. If you have any questions about the Mend platform, please contact your Mend Customer Success Manager or the Mend Customer Support Team.